just came back from Showtime at the Apollo. I'm still in New York, and I will never do this shit again. This shit was garbage. I knew from the jump that I was brought here as a setup to get booed. I knew from the start that it was a setup to get booed. I had my suspicions, but then when I got here, it got stronger and stronger. Because when I got the first call, because my audition was mediocre, but I kept getting emails from them about, oh, come to the show, and phone calls, come to the show. So I just gave it the benefit of the doubt and decided to come anyway. Well, before I get into it, things that I didn't like is, at least with America's Got Talent, the 5 songs that you choose, they choose because they got to get the songs through clearance. That's it. The 5 songs you choose is good. One of those songs is going to be a song that you do. This one, Apollo, I had to give like 20 song choices, literally. The first 10, it was going to be BNGB, one of my favorites. I Don't Want to Lose Your Love. But before then, she gave me a suggestion saying Amazing Grace. You know I do dance type of music. Why would you choose Amazing Grace? I said, no, I don't want to do that one. And then that's when she chose, from the list that I gave her, BNGB. Okay, then a few days later, she changed it. Again, it was going to be In Vogue. I had 2 choices, In Vogue, Free Your Mind, or either Gloria Estefan, Rhythm Is Gonna Get You. Really? Now that, I said no to that. Then she said, send her about 5 more songs. So that was 15 song choices instead of 20. But I sent 5, and it narrowed down to 2. One was Rhythm Is a Dancer, and I forgot who sang that one. And CC Peniston's Finally. So they chose Finally. So I got there and stuff. So I chose that. And what kind of threw me off is she wanted me to also send her a video of me singing live, and I did. Okay, so they sent that. So I'm like, well, maybe it wasn't the setup to get me booed. Maybe it wasn't. So I decided to come anyway. Luckily, I'm glad I didn't come for no damn 10 damn days, because I heard they didn't do jack shit for 10 days. They had them just sitting here in the city for just 10 days, and they didn't do anything until Friday. So, I mean, that's just ridiculous. Been here for 2 weeks for nothing. Unless, you know, you just want to make a vacation out of it. You got a job or school, it's like, no. So, I came here the last 3 days. And I'm glad it was the last 3 days. And, okay, so yesterday we got to rehearse, and it was good. The producers, it was good. And one of the producers told me, well, it was 1,000 times better than your actual audition at the audition in Atlanta. And I'm like, yeah, that was another red flag. I'm like, wait a minute, why would they bring me out here then if my audition wasn't so good? I'm like, these bitches got me out here to boo my ass. I'm like, well, maybe not. Still the spirit of optimism. Well, maybe not. I'll give another chance. Maybe not. You know, I went out there. Okay, so I went up here anyway. So I'm okay, looking forward to it anyway. Another thing that I didn't like was the wardrobe. They decide what outfits you wear. Now this, they told me to bring something black, a black kind of clubbish outfit. So I brought that. But I was gonna bring leggings, but I couldn't find them, so I just threw some jeans on. And during rehearsals, you know, people from wardrobe, well, they didn't like your outfit, changing it to some leggings. But they actually, one thing that they do, they buy the outfit that they want you to change into. They actually do. They actually buy the outfit and the shoes. So she told me that the jeans look like I was going grocery shopping. Oh, it looks hot at the top, but the jeans look like you're going grocery shopping. I'm like, okay. I actually like the jeans better because they're more comfortable. But at the same time, I did like the leggings because I can do the high kicks higher than with the jeans on. So, it's just so much stuff crammed into my head right now. Let me just say, what else? Let me just slow it down. Oh, I could not be in no police segregation because that's just all stuff that you witnessed. There's just so many stuff that she just crammed into your head that she's trying to get out. Let me see what else happened. Oh, we got back. Okay, when you get backstage, you get interviewed. Everything is rehearsed. They want everybody to get in a circle together and look at the look at the monitor backstage, because you get to see the person's performance and make reactions about it, whether you like it or not, whether you like their act or not. You get to make criticisms or whatever. We had to, each person that go on stage, we had to look at each other. Oh, what are you thinking about the performance? Oh, I think they're great. Nobody gave bad reviews, but oh, I think they're great. And you had to say all that. That's all rehearsed. And each person get interviewed by the people from producers. And one of the people that's whole skank bag hoe, Adrian from the Rio, that stupid ass bitch, fucking Mexican. Anyway, she was cutting her eyes at me during it, before the interview, way across the room. And I'm like, no, that bitch didn't, you know. But they did the interview, she was all fake, and oh, how you feeling about being in New York and all of that mess. But then after that fiasco on stage, she kind of smirked. Looking at me kind of smirking, I looked at her like, bitch, I know you didn't. Your damn C-level, bottom of the barrel. Hell, your life is one big boo, bitch. You the one did damn threesomes. You the one taking it up the ass, down the throat, and ain't no telling where else to keep your little C-list damn job, bitch. And anyway, when I got on stage, they wanted to exploit my job that I do, my 9-to-5 that I do security. And you got Steve. His damn chimp face, damn barely surviving ass. He got to damn grovel at the feet of the black community and the Apollo to keep his damn career alive. So anyway, before that, I heard him say something about security, security. That's another red flag, because backstage, she was one of the producers. Oh, they're not going to mention your job. He's not going to say anything until he asks you, and you can tell him. But then, before I was introduced, oh, we have, she's a security guard. Like, that supposed to be something bad. Yeah, motherfucker, it pays the bills. And what I get paid out here that you're paying me, this $55 a day, I get paid more than that at my job. So fuck you. You know, the way that sound, that's how I was backstage too. And you had that slimy ass damn producer backstage. Oh no, I didn't turn your microphone off. Your microphone wasn't turned off. It was turned off. By the time I did this first dance move, instant boos. They didn't even give me a chance. I started singing, microphone cut off. That's what I knew instantly, that it was a setup from the beginning, from the jump. Or maybe if it wasn't, somebody behind the scenes say, they probably had a listener acts that they gonna boo, that they gonna cheer for. They probably picked me to boo or whatever. But I showed my ass. Not literally, but I showed my ass when I, fuck y'all, motherfucker, fuck y'all. They really couldn't hear me because I was on a microphone and it was off. You know, fuck y'all, motherfucker, y'all, fuck y'all. Then I started doing cartwheels. Sandman came out, started dancing with him. Fuck that shit. I'm going to own that motherfucker. Fuck you. And Apollo is the bottom of the barrel when it comes to reality shows. Anyway, when it comes to competition reality shows, click up America's Got Talent. Click up X Factor. Click up Idol. How many of those individual performances, not the celebrity performers, but the individual performers, how many views they get? They get hundreds of thousands to millions. Click up Apollo, and they individual performance on Amateur Night. They get like 2,000 to 3,000. So Apollo's at the bottom of the barrel. It's at the